Discoveries changing what we know about the Underground Railroad. As Kaya Edwards shows us, historians discovered an abolitionist who was once thought lost, traced back here to Minnesota.
Ultimately, it's very much like science. You're looking for evidence, you have a theory.
Historian Karen Sieber just launched this website.
Newspaper records.
After 7 years of research, findingmoses.org shares new details about Moses Dixon.
There's always been a gap in how we talk about his life.
In the 1840s and 50s, Dixon ran two secretive abolitionist organizations leading former slaves to freedom through the Underground Railroad.
It was kind of thought that he was living under the radar.
Sieber's new research places Dixon in St. Paul during that time.
I was able to find him through his wife.
The couple was listed in territorial records just before Minnesota became a state.
Once I was able to locate them there, it was like a Pandora's box of other things, and there's court cases he's involved in and letters to the editor, and he owned numerous businesses.
Sieber found out Dixon ran two restaurants roughly where the XL Energy Center stands now, and that he was a barber in downtown St. Paul.
It's a chance to really kind of rethink how we think about the Black Freedom Network of the era, and really breaking it out of the South and thinking about what was the Midwest's role.
Dixon crossed paths with Dred Scott, and Sieber has identified about 25 others in his network, people she plans to also feature on the Finding Moses website.
I'm a white woman named Karen. I realize that it's odd that I do Black history for a living. And this is how I can best be an ally, is to be able to bring some of these stories to light.
Kaya Edwards, Care 11 News.